Hi, hello, how are you? So today in this short video, I'm going to talk about stock selection. Stock selection is the number one challenge that traders and investors face. So I actually call it as market selection also, because when you say stock selection, you restrict yourself to only stocks. But when you say market selection, it goes beyond just stocks. It includes indices, Nifty, Bank Nifty, and then commodities and all the gold, silver, crude oil and all that stuff. So ideally, if you ask me, I call it as market selection. So, but since everybody calls it as stock selection, so let's talk about some of the criterias that people use for selecting the right stocks for making excellent profits. So one of the biggest criteria, if you can ever look at when selecting a stock or a market, is that market or stock should be liquid. There should be adequate buyers and sellers. It should not so happen that the market moves up because you are buying and selling, you are buying a share, or the market goes down because you are selling a share. In that case, the challenge could be that you are not getting buyers and sellers for your stock. So be careful, be watchful. And if you are watching this video, just write in the comments, and that will also be a declaration for you that I will trade in liquid stocks. Just type liquid stocks in the comments, so that it goes into your brain, the cells and the entire body, and you will not make a mistake of buying stocks which are not liquid and get into a huge problem. That's criteria number one. Then it's not a criteria, but more of a knowledge, is you can look at Nifty 50 stocks, very liquid, large cap and all of that stuff. Sorry about that. That's a surprise element. Then you have Nifty 100, and then future stocks. Nifty 500 is another thing that we use for mostly long-term and investing stuff. So this is one category that you can actually look at. Then again, the stock selection differs completely from strategy to strategy. In fact, if you ask me, when you want to go into detail, for example, which stock should I buy today, or which stock should I buy tomorrow for this particular strategy? So it differs from strategy to strategy. For example, we have an early morning strategy for which we select only 3 or 4 stocks based on certain criteria and all of that stuff. In my coaching program, I actually teach them the proper selection criteria for this particular strategy. Use this. So it should be this particular criteria, this criteria and all of that stuff. So it varies from strategy to strategy. Again, as I mentioned, indices versus stocks, you have to carefully pick up whether you want to trade only in stocks. Why not indices? Nifty and Bank Nifty. How many of you love Nifty and Bank Nifty? Type Nifty. If you are an ardent follower of Nifty and Bank Nifty, type Nifty in the comment box. I would like to see who all loves trading in Nifty and Bank Nifty. Then the everybody is fond of this top gainers and top losers. Top gainers are somebody who are top gainers for the day, top gainers for the year, month, week, it can be anything. So based on that, there are a lot of strategies that are built around top gainers and top losers. So this can be your selection criteria. Then if you are not subscribed yet, why? Subscribe now, hit the bell button and get some amazing ideas from me. So the next again is pre-market. This is one that we use very consistently for one of our strategy. So pre-market closes at 9:08, and you will get again different set of stocks, top gainers and top losers, and then you can add some criteria and accordingly trade. Then news-based and results. So how many stocks results are pending today? So that's another strategy that many people use for either trading in options, futures, or even in equity. And again, news based. If there is, for example, recently there was Infosys news, people were trading in that, that they selected Infosys as a stock to trade. So if you're looking for some tool help, here are the two help, two scanners that you can actually look at, Charting and Streak.tech. Both of them have excellent scanners. Go ahead and use them and tell me which one did you like the more, Charting or Streak, or if you're already using both of them, which is your favorite, just tell me and I'll reply with mine. So comment intraday if you're looking at more intraday strategies, comment positional if you're looking at more positional strategies. Accordingly, I'll make videos for you. If you've liked this video, click on like. If you did not like this video, no worries, you can still click on like only. Or if you don't like what I'm talking, click on dislike, that's also fine. But to me, what is important is, are you here or not? Are you getting some value from this? So that's all from my side for this very short, very informative video. And see you in the next video. Bye-bye.